Production line installation. The equipment of the entire peanut butter production line is based on the vibrating feeding bin. Therefore, after receiving the equipment according to the prior layout drawings, you need to determine the location of the feeding bin first. Then install the pre-treatment production line. Hoist, picking belt. Continuous roasting and cooling integrated machine in reverse order. Pre-treatment installation part. To determine the location of the feeding bin, first install the hoist. Before that, you need to reconfirm the level of the ground. All the equipment must be on the same level. The 4M bucket elevator is hoisted and placed upright after hoisting. The foot of the elevator is marked first. And the fixing process will not be done temporarily. Then place the picking belt. After the picking belt is hoisted in place, move it manually to make the end of the picking motor, discharge end, match the inlet of the hoist, aligned and directly above the inlet of the hoist to prevent leakage. Then adjust the 6 anchor cups of the picking belt and place the level on the conveyor belt for calibration. To make the picking conveyor belt level, then install the peeling equipment. Since the main structure of the peeling equipment is a vibrating structure, it is necessary to ensure the level of the ground where the peeling machine is placed. Otherwise, it will affect the stability of the structure. The peeling machine is equipped with Shakerin, which is connected by PVC pipes. When placed, pay attention to the alignment of the inlet of the fan and the outlet of the skin suction device. The height of the suction device and the discharge screen needs to be adjusted first and adjusted by 4 bolts. Then install the horizontal PVC pipe and then install the vertical PVC pipe. Next, hoist the 3-meter high bucket elevator, which is the same as the 4-meter bucket elevator. Place it vertically, make a mark. Adjust the position of the outlet and the hopper of the peeler to prevent leakage. Then hoist the continuous roasting and cooling integrated machine. It should be noted that the 10 feet of the equipment should also be level, because this equipment is a large hole, the unlevel feet will affect the structure and use. During the placement process, slowly align the outlet of the continuous roasting and cooling integrated machine with the inlet of the 3-meter bucket elevator, so that the outlet is in the center and directly above the inlet. Through the reverse installation of the front, the position of the front plate elevator can be determined finally. And then the level of the foot needs to be adjusted. The outlet of the plate elevator is aligned with the continuous roasting and cooling integrated machine into the hopper, and the distance direction is slightly adjusted. The hopper is closed to avoid leakage. It is necessary to pay attention to the equipment of the overall pre-treatment production line, and the axes should overlap as much as possible to improve the uniformity and continuity of the conveying of materials. Because the pre-treatment production line is matched by multiple independent equipment, there is no more complicated connection, and it is relatively simple. So far, the hoisting and placing of the pre-treatment part is completed. Now start to place the butter grinding part. The butter grinder machine is placed directly below the discharge port of the feeding bin, and then the 300L storage tank, rotor pump, and 800L mixing tank are aligned and placed in order. Followed by the rotor pump, homogenizer, 500L Sotridge tank C0, rotor pump, butter cooling machine placed in sequence. Then there is the chiller, which is placed near the butter cooling machine or in another separate room. Then there are 500L storage tank E0, rotor pump, vacuum tank and its vacuum pump and water tank, rotor pump. Peanut go through from storage tank to grinding machine. After grinding, then go proceeds with butter processing steps. Next, introduce the grinding machine installation and commissioning parts. Grinding machines have three parts construction, including the overhead grinder, the below grinder, and support frame for grinders. The overhead grinder has an inlet feeder, while the below grinder has a piping connecting with the overhead grinder. So firstly, arrange the support frame for grinders, which is on the bottom of storage tank. Then install the below grinder. Finally install the overhead grinder. Then assemble and install all parts of grinders. Firstly install the outlet of overhead grinder and inlet of below grinder. There shows how to install the piping connection. Put sealing washer between piping and the below grinder. Then put on clamp and tighten. Put sealing washer between piping and the overhead grinder. Then adjust the height of connection piping by rotating inlet of below grinder. Adjust correctly and put on clamp. Adjust the final height and coordination, then lock down the two clamps, and finish the connection of two grinder. Next, install the inlet hopper of overhead grinder. Firstly, put white sealing washer into overhead grinder. Bring up inlet hopper. Clockwise rotation installation, tighten and finish. After finishing installing grinders, there needs to check the stop screw of below grinder. Please don't adjust the stop screw, which is the lowest limited position. Generally, we rotate handles counterclockwise of the two grinders firstly, to increase the fineness of butter and keep 80-100 meshes fineness. Next, supply cool water for the grinder. There are inlet and outlet for cooling water. Connect the inlet and outlet piping accordingly. Same movement for the overhead grinder. The cooling water shall parallel form connection. Same cooling water inlet piping for two grinders and outlet for another same piping. They recommend to use cooling water supplying when grinders working. Please arrange the butter grinding part according to the drawings. and adjusted in conjunction with the pipeline dot. Finally, the equipment of the packaging part is placed, which is connected to the packaging area through a long pipeline. The 500L storage tank G0, the forehead paste filling machine, the labeling machine, the bottleneck heat shrinking furnace, and the cuff packing machine are placed in sequence. Production line adjustment and trial run. After the overall production line is installed, we need to fine-tune each of our equipment before it can be used. The first elevator, here is the starting point of the production line, and also the raw material inlet. The material is poured into the hopper, and then would be lifted by the scraper. It is necessary to detect whether the screw into the hopper is loose, and then fine-tune the tension device below, and turn the nut to adjust the tension of the conveyor belt to maintain a medium tension, because the long-term use of the equipment will cause gaps in the chain. It is necessary to make the transmission with sufficient tension to lift the animal material. Next, we will introduce the motor reducer of the elevator. The air valve, oil cap, should be adjusted on the reducer to release the gas in the chassis dot. For the continuous roasting and cooling integrated machine, adjust the height of the feed. Observe the scale line, turn the hand wheel to adjust. Generally, the thickness of the material layer is 3-5 cm. Then turn the fixed hand wheel to fix the ply baffle and tighten it dot. Next, on the left and right sides of the feed inlet, slowly lift the cover upwards by the handle. Then pull the upper part of the cover to disengage the device. And then slowly lift the entire cover and place it aside. You can see the conveyor belt tensioning device of the continuous roasting and cooling integrated machine. Twist the nut to adjust the tension of the conveyor belt, so that the chain and the sprocket on the mesh belt are closely attached to ensure the smooth delivery dot. Next, you need to inject grease to the bearing of the sprocket. You can see that there is a grease injection port on the outside of the bearing. It needs to be injected every 2 to 3 days. Use a grease gun to align the grease injection port to add 3 to 4. The second grease injection makes the bearing fully lubricated, and lithium-based bearing grease is usually used. The following bearings are also needed. Of course, the other side of the equipment inlet also needs the same treatment dot. On the handwheel rod of the adjustment layer, there are also bearings that need to be greased and refilled 3 to 4 times dot. The side panel of the device can be removed by lifting the handle. Then you can see the heating tube and the cleaning port. The cleaning port needs to be cleaned regularly to prevent the residue from producing peculiar smell dot. The observation port of the furnace cavity, the searchlight part. The searchlight needs to check whether the wiring is stable. When all the cleaning ports and searchlights have been checked and processed, reinstall the side panels. You need to align the lower hooks of the side panels first, and then align the upper hooks to fix the side panels downward dot. There are two moisture outlets on the top of the equipment. The valve needs to be opened, and then connected to the exhaust pipe system to discharge moisture. The equipment should be connected to the exhaust piping system at the place close to the cooling discharge to remove the hot air from the material to cool down dot. After the elevator anchor bolts are fixed, turn the box screws on the two sides below, open the box. Adjust the height of the nut and tighten the elevator hopper. Conveyor belt to make the material better and inject grease into the bearing dot. Then adjust the height of the feeding baffle of the bucket elevator. Loosen the two nuts, pull the baffle. And then fix the baffle so that the material enters the hopper and rises dot. Next, we will demonstrate the disassembly of the side plates of the lower bucket elevator. Each side plate has 6 rebound buckles, which can be pulled one by one dot. This is the hopper. The hopper is fixed on the belt, and the belt drives the up and down movement to transport materials. Next, install the germ collection tray of the peeler. Slowly push the longer side of the tray into the peeler from the side, let the tray slide on the angle iron, and make the axis of the tray coincide with the axis of the peeler. Collect the germs of peanuts dot. Then the baffle of the peeler into the hopper. First loosen the fixed hand wheel, then lift the baffle. And then tighten the hand wheel. Adjust the height according to the size of the peanuts. Generally 2 to 3 times the diameter of the peanuts, or about 2 centimeters. Ensure that the peanut kernels are evenly distributed on the vibration plate dot. Adjust the gap between the rubber rollers of the peeling machine to ensure the peeling effect. Check the gap between the two rubber rollers by turning the hand wheel and observing the scale line, as well as the observation port above the outer cover, so that the upper rubber roller is away from the fixed rubber roller 6 to 7 mm. The distance between the lower rubber roller and the fixed rubber roller is 4-6 mm. In the same way, the adjustment scale line on the other side can be the same dot. The motor on the top of the shaker needs to be connected to the exhaust system to discharge the air sucked by the fan to the outside. And the customer needs to match the pipeline by himself. There is a peanut skin collection device below. When the peeling equipment and the fan stop, open the gate. The peanut skins can be discharged and need to be cleaned and collected. After cleaning, close the gate again to prevent air leakage after the fan is started. After the peanuts are peeled, they will fall from the peeling machine to the picking belt. 4 to 5 people will pick the peanuts and then continue to move on to the next equipment. In the same way, adjust the feeding baffle of the bucket elevator. Pay attention to the size of the baffle opening to avoid material leakage caused by excessive feeding. Next, adjust the feeding hopper. It should be noted that the feeding hopper is 220V/50Hz/1-phase, which is connected to the 3-phase electricity. After powering on, press the switch button and adjust the knob to control the feeding speed of the feeding hopper. There is a fuse on the control board to prevent the equipment from overcurrent. If the equipment cannot start, check the fuse and check whether the circuit is overcurrent. There is a baffle gate at the exit of the feeding hopper, which can control the material not to leak from both sides of the discharge plate, and at the same time control the amount of feeding. Adjust the height of the baffle gate through the wing nut, and then tighten it.
Mm-hmm. and the materials goes orderly into the peeling roller through the evaporation. After extrusion of peanuts, kernel and skin have been fully separated. The absorption of the peanut tester is to achieve the purpose of peeling. While shedding the germ discharged by the sieving machine, the peeled peanuts will go to the key link of peanut butter production, butter grinding. High-speed rotation on the fixation. Fast shear of rotors, grinding peanuts, so that all your molecules precipitated after roasting jammed up, bringing peanut butter out of the grinder. The filling of peanuts requires a suitable temperature. For this reason, the entire production line is equipped with a special butter cooling machine. The ideal temperature required for filling is reached through the reverse flow of cooling water and source in different sandwich layers and through heat exchange. Finally, a linear filling machine is to lift the peanut butter from the paste pump and supporting pipes to the hopper of the filling machine. Through vertical filling, automatic capping, electromagnetic sealing, labeling and coating, etc., the various packages of peanut butter on display in supermarkets are presented in front of us.